Our next speaker is Rajendra Gupta, who will be speaking on why the government needs to promote information therapy. Rajendra is an international healthcare policy expert. He's an advisor to the World Healthcare Congress, USA and Europe. And he's also part of the Quality Control Council of the Government of India. Rajendra.
Thank you, Rajesh. See, I have to speak on a topic where least happens, the government side. So I'll be speaking the least, you'll have fewer slides. So if I were to start, why the government needs to promote information therapy? So you have to see from three angles. One is that the huge burden that India has in terms of chronic diseases. And the second thing is about the rural and illiterate population that we have. So I'm going to give you some data of why we need to promote information therapy. See, let's see the economic survey of 2009 and 2010. That says 13% of the rural population have access to PHC, 33% of the population have access to sub-center, 9.6% of the rural population have access to hospitals, 28.3% of the rural population have access to a dispensary clinic, 34% of the rural population have access to diagnostic centers. Only 24% of the rural areas have access to healthcare facilities. So certainly if you're looking at infrastructure addressing the issue of rural health, it's never going to happen. So the next thing, chronic diseases. This is the data which is taken from all the credible sources. So 14% of the patients have arthritis, which is 140 million. 10% of patients have hypertension. 5% patients with diabetes, which is too less, it's underestimated. It's actually about 12%, so we have around 120 million patients. There are more than 100 million undiagnosed patients with diabetes and hypertension. India already has 150 million elderly patients. We have not included patients with other chronic diseases like asthma, COPD, CVD, cancer, psychiatric disorders, which is huge. It will take another 23 years, which was the recent study of the high-level group on universal coverage, which said it will take 23 years to fill the gap between the number of doctors we need and the nurses and the current workload that is existing. So for sure, if you're looking at infrastructure, solving the problem is near to impossible happening. By the time we reach 23 years, the patient load would have gone much beyond. This is a recent study of ICMR. I mean, if you see, this is the prevalence of diabetes. So in Jharkhand, you have 11.14. In Chandigarh, you have 13. Basically, there's no difference in urban and rural area when it comes to Chandigarh. In Maharashtra, it's 9.1. And these are the most recent studies. This is glaring. Half of urban women and one-third of rural women suffer from hypertension. One-fifth of hypertensive women were under treatment, and less than 4% are controlled. So 96% are still not controlled. And this is as recent as September 11. We are in October. So half of urban and one-fourth of rural women were aware of their condition. So 50% were not aware even. In rural, 75%. So hypertension is directly responsible for 57% of the deaths due to stroke and 24% fatalities due to heart attack. So India does not have a twin burden, you know, as we hear every time. India has a triple burden. The triple burden is a huge population, over 400 million chronic patients, and lack of awareness amongst people. What we need to do? Fuse IT with IT, that is information therapy with information technology, as people like NIP and other people are doing. I think we need more people. When last time I addressed this conference, I said, would like to see more patient groups, like Vandana is doing a fantastic job. I think we need more such people in the country, but fuse that knowledge with information technology. Imagine that we have close to now, I think 845 million cell phones. How many are active? I don't know, but I hear it's around 650 million active cell phones. So we definitely have a mobile coverage which can take information therapy together to the people and empower them. Take this movement to schools and colleges. People don't understand what is health and what is nutrition. These are two different things. I mean, when they take food, they think it is nutrition. Good food is not good nutrition. There's a difference in it. Take it to workplaces. Use the medium of mobile, expand reach and empower patients. We need people like Vanna and Prabhakar who are sitting here in every sphere of chronic diseases, in every sphere of health. We need at least 100 national patient self-help groups. And if you really want to make patients control the disease. I mean, infrastructure, I believe, is not. See, I work with policymakers, and the biggest problem I see is we don't have money. Where we have money, we don't have the vision. So in August, I was a part of the committee that formed the NCD policy for the Government of India. I mean, I could clearly see that, you know, I was a misfit there because people don't understand where we are heading. They have money. In fact, for the 12th five-year plan, the government has asked for 55,000 crores to just tackle NCDs. But they don't know how it's going to be used. And if it's going to be used in the current form, it's not going to be used at all, kind of. So the government should focus on creating awareness, providing care to BPL, and regulating healthcare. But sorry to say, when government behaves like undiagnosed patient when it comes to healthcare policy. This has been my experience working with them, though I would say a lot has changed. You know, now things are not the way they were 5 years back. The government wants to listen, you know, what we can do. So they have been inviting people like us. There are more people like me who participate in such deliberations. They ask, but I think group like this, which is very concerned about health, should form a collective voice, you know, with people like Anirudh, you know, being in the front and with so many people. If you can give concrete suggestions to the government on how to promote information therapy or create awareness and sensitization, I'm sure the government will implement, or few state governments would implement. Because today we have policymakers who want to do things. There is a recent announcement that says we will scan 200 million people with diabetes and hypertension by March 2012. It won't happen. But even if 10% happens, it is a big number for healthcare system and for the people and the population of this country. So I think it's our job to go and give them executable plans so it works. That's all I had to say. And if you have any questions, you can write. See, one of the roles I do is I'm on the governing, this four-member team that the government has formed on quality in healthcare called Quality Council of India. So if you have any suggestions to improve the quality of healthcare, we can work together, I'll be happy to do. And also join us for Telemedicon. We are focusing on using technology for healthcare. And we have a big congress. You can join us, and you know, whatever we can do together, we'll be happy to do. Thanks so much.